This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Key Longfellow, born Baby Kelly, later named Pamela, December 9, 1944, is an American novelist, playwright, theatrical producer, theater director and entrepreneur with dual citizenship in Britain. She is best known in the United States for her novel The Secret Magdalene, 2005. This is among her recent works exploring the divine feminine in England. She is likely best known as the widow of Vivian Stanshall, the late musician, lead singer of the Bonzo Dog Doo-Dah Band, songwriter, author, radio broadcaster and wit. Longfellow started writing seriously after Stanshall's death in 1995. Her first two novels, China Blues 1989 and Chasing Women 1993, and the recent Houdini Heart 2011, are mysteries and thrillers. In April 2013, the first three titles of her Sam Russo Mysteries were published, part of a noir series set in and around New York City in the late 1940s. Walksaway Woman, about a neglected Arizona housewife walking out into the Sonoran Desert to die, was published in December 2013. Contents 1. Early life and education. 2. Children, marriages, family and early work. 3. Music and plays. 4. Writing career. 5. Books. 6. Movies. 7. Theater. 8. References. 9. External links. Early life and education. She was born as Baby Kelly on December 9, 1944, on Staten Island, New York, to Andrea Lorraine Kelly, who was barely 16 years old. Born November 17, 1928. The young mother finally named the child Pamela when required to by the authorities, then put her baby in foster care while she worked at many jobs during the last of the war years. When the infant Pamela contracted pneumonia, she was removed from the foster home. The girl was taken in by a relative of her mother's father. Pamela was removed from this home when it was discovered this relative's husband was abusive. Pamela was never told about her biological father until she was 27. She was told only that he was Native American but never learned his name. Within 2 years, Kelly, briefly assuming care of her child, left New York to resettle in Marin County, California, near her older married sister, Rosemary Anderson. Indiana. Marin Anderson cared for Pamela until she left for Samoa, then to Texas with her own child and new husband. Recently returned from World War II, she turned the girl back to her mother. Kelly met and married a U.S. Navy man named Clifford Longfellow, claiming Pamela again at the age of 4. He adopted her and she took his surname over the next several years. The family moved frequently, as he was assigned to New York's Brooklyn Navy Yard, Hawaii's Pearl Harbor, Mare Island and Long Beach in California, and Norfolk Naval Base in Virginia due to frequent moves. Longfellow attended a different school for each grade except the years spent on Oahu between duty stations. The family lived with her adopted grandfather, Lindsay Ray Longfellow, at his home in Larkspur, California. Pamela relied on him for family, and learned to enjoy his pastime of going to horse races. Longfellow graduated from Redwood High School in Larkspur in her junior and senior years. She attended only those classes that interested her and cut others. Determined to become a writer, she spent time with painters, poets, and musicians in Sausalito, and discovered what remained of the Beat Generation in North Beach at 19. Longfellow had a dramatic experience which she now considers an occurrence of gnosis. Not understanding her experience then and suffering panic attacks, she voluntarily entered the state mental institution at Napa, California. There she was diagnosed, without benefit of a doctor, as a severe psycho-neurotic. Children, marriages, family and early work. On June 21, 1963, at age 18, Longfellow gave birth to her first child, daughter Sydney. Longfellow, who became a painter and photographer as an adult in 1964, she acted in her only movie, Once a Thief, starring Alain Delon and directed by Ralph Nelson, in a part written for her by the film's screenwriter Zekiel Marco. In 1967, she moved with her daughter to New York City, where she worked briefly as a fashion model, and then as a writer for care. She moved to Montana, where she lived and worked for a year on a ranch on the Blackfeet Indian Reservation as a member of Vista. She sailed to Europe, living for a time in Nice and Paris. Back in New York City, Longfellow worked for the promoter Bill Graham in his Millard Booking Agency. In 1972, she met Robin G., the manager of the English folk band Fairport Convention, and moved with him to England. They were together for 5 years and she became a British citizen during this period. Longfellow wrote occasionally for English music magazines. A year before her mother died suddenly at the age of 44 from an embolism, Kelly told Longfellow, then 27 years old, for the first time about her biological father. He was a Native American of Iroquois ancestry, Kelly had met him at art school but never told Pamela his name or that of the school. Longfellow never met him nor could she find him. Longfellow returned to California in 1975 and stayed there for a time. In 1977, she flew back to England. There she met Vivian Stanshall, frontman for the Bonzo Dog Band. In 1977, they moved into a houseboat moored on the River Thames between Chertsey and Shepparton. On August 16, 1979, they had a daughter, Silky Longfellow Stanshall, named after a favorite racehorse from Longfellow's childhood. On September 9, 1981, they married in the register office at Sunbury on Thames. Music and plays. Longfellow and Stanshall wrote radio plays and songs together. In 1980, she edited Stanshall's only book, Sir Henry at Rawlinson End. It was not a financial success. In 2004, Sea Urchin Editions published the script of the original Stinkfoot, with an introduction by Longfellow. In 2010, it was produced in Bristol in a concert version. In 1986, Longfellow and Stanshall closed the theatre and moved into the Bristol home of their friend, actor David Rappaport. Writing career. Longfellow began writing in earnest. Her first novel was China Blues, 1989, a historical thriller set in San Francisco's Chinatown. In 1923, it was the object of an auction which HarperCollins won to publish in England. Doubleday, New York published an American edition in 1990. China Blues was subsequently translated into Spanish, Swedish, Hebrew, Czech, German, and optioned by Richard D. Zanuck and David Brown. Longfellow's second book, Chasing Women, 1993, was a comedy murder mystery set in New York City just after the Great Crash of 1929. It was also published in England by HarperCollins Grafton imprint. Later it was optioned by an Australian team of female writer, producers. The process of attempting to adapt her novels as films taught Longfellow a great deal about the mainstream movie business from mid-1990, when she was very ill with pneumonia, until the death of her husband in March 1995. Longfellow divided her time between a small farm in Brattleboro, Vermont, and Stanshall's flat in Muswell Hill, London. She and their daughter Silky hoped that Stanshall would end his destructive habits and they could reunite as a family after Stanshall's accidental death in a fire in 1995. Longfellow stopped writing for a time. When she slowly got back to work, she found a new voice, very different from the one expressed in her earlier works as a widow. Her work has grappled with loss of her husband, her difficult childhood, and spiritual yearning. She has recognized that her experience at age 19 was an event of gnosis since being widowed. Longfellow has published by the first name of Key, pronounced as in sky, a name which Stanshall had given her from a vivid dream he'd had while living on the Searchlight based on her novel, The Secret Magdalene. She was invited to contribute to Dan Burstein's nonfiction book Secrets of Mary Magdalene 2006. Her novel, The Secret Magdalene 2005, has been translated into Spanish, Czech, Chinese, Icelandic, and French. It was optioned in 2014 to be adapted as a feature film by director Nancy Savoca. Longfellow's novel, Flow Down Like Silver, Hypatia of Alexandria 2009, is about the 4th, 5th century mathematician and philosopher who lived in Egypt. It is the second volume in her trilogy on the divine feminine or Shakti. She rewrote the script for Stinkfoot, a comic opera, to be staged in Bristol, England. Cutting it to 2 hours. Peter Moss served as musical director at the same time she was working on her first nonfiction, a memoir of her married life called The Last Showboat, an illustrated memoir of Vivian Stanshall, The Old Profanity Showboat. In early April 2013, Longfellow published her first three titles in a series of murder mysteries featuring Sam Russo, A Private Eye in 1940s Staten Island, New York. These are in the noir tradition. In December 2013, Longfellow published Walks Away Woman, a novel she had written in 2002 when she was living in Tucson, Arizona. It explores a middle-aged woman who walks into the desert, having given up on her life. Books. 1989 China Blues as Pamela Longfellow, HarperCollins Britain. ISBN 978-0-586-20390-3, Doubleday US. ISBN 978-0-385-26048-0-1993 Chasing Women as Pamela Longfellow, HarperCollins Britain. ISBN 978-0-246-13677-0-2003 Stinkfoot, an English comic opera as Key Longfellow Stanshall, with Vivian Stanshall. See Urchin Editions English Language, Netherlands. ISBN 978 978-90-75342-13-0-2005 The Secret Magdalene, as Key Longfellow EO Books Worldwide ISBN 978-0-9759255-3-9-2006 Secrets of Mary Magdalene, Contributing Writer CDs Books ISBN 1-59315-205-1-2007 The Secret Magdalene, Crown Random House, English Language World Rights ISBN 978-0-307-34666-7-2009 Flow Down Like Silver, Hypatia of Alexandria, a novel, EO Books Worldwide ISBN 978-0-9759255-9-1-2011 Houdini Heart, EO Books, April 2011 ISBN 978-0-9759255-1-5-2012 China Blues, a reissue by EO Books, February 2012 ISBN 978-0-9759255-7-7 Being developed as a television series 2013 Shadow Roll, a Sam Russo Mystery Case 1 EO Books Worldwide ISBN 978-1937819002-2013 Good Dog, Bad Dog, a Sam Russo Mystery Case 2 EO Books Worldwide ISBN 978-1937819040-2013 The Girl in the Next Room, a Sam Russo Mystery Case 3 EO Books Worldwide ISBN 978-1937819057-2013 Walks Away Woman, EO Books Worldwide ISBN 978-1937819903-2014 The Last Great Pulp Fiction Writer, North Beach Girl, Scandal on the Sand Contributing Writer Stark House Press ISBN 978-1933585-8655-7-2015 Dead on the Rocks Case 4 EO Books Worldwide ISBN 978-1937819125 Movies 1965 Once a Thief, Actress 1978 Sir Henry at Rawlinson End, Charisma Films, Screenwriter 2007 The Secret Magdalene, optioned in 2014-2010 Stinkfoot, a comic opera, Playwright, pre-production in 2012-2013 The Last Showboat, co-screenwriter, in pre-production Theatre Stinkfoot, a comic opera, staged in Bristol, England and London, England, revived in concert version in 2010 References Carrot Comments on Houdini Heart Carrot Sam Russo Mysteries IoBooks Scum retrieved 2 August 2013. Carrot The Stanshalls on the Thames Carrot The BBC produced a documentary program about it, aired in September 1983 as the Bristol Showboat Saga Carrot Carrot Stinkfoot Script Carrot Longfellow's first two novels Carrot Longfellow's Change of Direction Carrot Recognition of Gnosis Carrot A.B. Director Nancy Savoca A Cowgirl in Cinema's Wild West, TorontoCom archived June 17, 2012, at the Wayback Machine Carrot Key Longfellow, Flow Down Like Silver Hypatia of Alexandria 9780975925591 EO Books 2009 Amazon Carrot Interview with Longfellow Barnes and Noble Reading San Francisco November 2008 No Publisher Carrot Stinkfoot Concert on the Thecla Carrot Amazon.com Houdini Heart Carrot Horror Writers Association Blog Horrorg retrieved 2 August 2013 Carrot A B C D E F G EO Books retrieved 2 August 2013. Authority Control WorldCat Identities VIAF, 19192672 Sudik, 0778668000